Good morning to all of you. There is a case of passing off which we dealt with in the law of torts. Once again, such type of case came before the Honorable Delhi High Court and single judge, Sri Justice C. Harishankar, restrained the other party from using manufacturing, advertising or any other way connecting with the cosmetic product. Actually, now advertising the cosmetic products which are deceptively similar to the registered products under Trademarks and Merchandise Act, they are prohibited. Now they are restrained. So this is a good case, and if you are dealing with the Trademarks and Merchandise Act or the so-called registration of trademarks as patent law, this will be a good case for you. That's why I am making this video. This is a case regarding Nivea. You may be seeing this. Nivea and Joy. This is the main difference between these two. But Nivea is the original product, whereas this Joy is the deceptively similar product. You may see it. Right. Now, this is a case relating to, you can understand it as Beast Dove. B-E-I-E-R-S, Beast of D-O-R-F, A-G versus RHS Global Private Limited 2020. So you can refer this case as in disposed CS number 48/2021 on 28 January 2021 by the Delhi High Court. Right here, it is clearly established that the product Joy is deceptively similar to the very famous product Nivea. Right now, these people, the owners of Nivea, that is simply we can call them Bizdorp or AG. This AG company instituted a civil suit against RHS Global Private Limited under Order 11. Rule 4 of the CPC, please remember Order 11, Rule 4, this is an amended rule for this commercial products, right? So the plaintiffs are the manufacturers or makers of the product Nivea, right? Which is very good for in healthy issues, or it is a very good cosmetic product brought from the cocoa butter, very, very, very smooth, useful for the dry skins, right? So they alleged that the product has been infringed or the trademark has been infringed by the defendant. Of course, you know, the plaintiff has got good reputation over a period of time. That's only they got the so-called registered trademark for the Nivea in a blue color. Of course, they have given the details also how it was infringed also they have given. See, the brand name is written white. The brand name is written white on blue background. Yes, Nivea is written in white on the blue background. So it contained a distinct blue color which can be easily identified. This blue color you can easily identify, very deep blue. And actually they have got the trademark or patent from the German WIPO, World Intellectual Property. So they have got it from the German office. And please remember, the cocoa butter is swirling in milk, swivelling in the milk. So similarly, this other product is called as Joy. They have written it in green and white, right? Similarly, they have reversed the cocoa butter. It is when it is swirling, Nivea, it is swirling this side, the reverse, but it is swirling the reverse side. So whatever it is. Right, so now the plaintiff says, or that is AG company says, that the trademark is almost, of course, trademark is definitely similar, but this is deceptively similar. Right, the Honorable Court has actually compared both these two, and it has viewed holistically seen. Prima facie, every purchaser who is every unwary purchaser, we can say, person who is not, and of average intelligence and imperfect recollection, definitely he will get confused on seeing the product. He will be confused whether it is Nivea or Joy, and thinking that it is Nivea, definitely he will purchase the same. Thereby, these people will definitely get some damages or their business will be down. So definitely it is infringement of the product. Therefore, the defendant and his agents, they are restrained from using, manufacturing, advertising or indirectly dealing in cosmetic products of this similar to the trademark. Totally they are restrained. Then injunction order was given, and definitely actually you may be knowing that the injunction order will be given under order 39. So they have to follow the procedure and they have definitely restrained themselves from all these things. Of course, a leverage, an exception was also given to them. It is needless to say that the defendant is at liberty to apply for a variation or modification of the order. Of course, if they are not satisfied, definitely they can go for that. That means they can say that they have changed the color, they are changing the color product. Now, in place of blue, if they keep red, okay, everybody will accept. So, that chance was also given to this company. So, anyway, it's a good case for this is a case of passing off, we can say, which will be done in the law of stars, right? Thank you.